welcome to another video. My name is Infinity and I am back with another continental knitting tutorial. Today I will be showing you guys how to knit the vertical bar line stitch. It is a two row repeat and you'll be able to see the results of the two row repeat relatively quick after you complete that second row pretty much. It is a very simple repeat and it has a little bit of stretch, but not a whole lot, so you might not want to use a stretchy cast on as I have done across the bottom here. But without further ado, I'm going to jump into this tutorial. For this stitch pattern, you will want to cast on in multiples of four and then add an additional two. And then row one, or our odd rows, will be the right side of our work, and you'll see that I have a handy little stitch marker here, and that just helps me keep track, even though it'll be very evident which side is the right side once you start working the pattern. Alright, so what we want to do for row one, our repeat, we are going to purl two. And if you're a beginner knitter, I do have several beginner level tutorials back on my channel, so if you're not familiar with purls yet, you can check out my tutorial on that back on my channel. Alright, I'm going to purl two, so I'm going to insert my needle purlwise and create that stitch, purl the next stitch. Okay, and now we are going to start our repeat by knitting two. There's two. We're going to bring the yarn forward and purl two. And purling the last two stitches. Alright, now we can move on to row two, which will give us our bars that are going across. Alright, so we're going to turn the work. For row two, we're going to leave the yarn to the back because we will start this row with a knit two. So I'm going to insert my needle knit wise, yarn over. Right, do that again. Okay, and now with the yarn in the back, I'll leave this back here, we're going to slip these two stitches purlwise. So I'm going to insert my needle into the next two stitches, like so, purlwise, with my yarn in the back, and I'm going to slide them off my needle, just like that. Okay, and then I'm going to knit the next two stitches. And that right there just gave us our first bar across on the right side of our work. Alright, so again, we are going to insert the tip of our needle into the next two stitches and slip them off purlwise. And we're going to knit two. And two. All the way across our project. Off two stitches and then we're going to knit the next two, or the last two in my case, off of our left hand needle, and that is the end of row two. And this is what the front side of our work looks like. So if you continue working this stitch, you will end up with a swatch similar to this one, or a project similar to this one. I would recommend using this maybe in a sweater with really accurate stitch count. So gauge swatch would be important for this stitch because it doesn't have a whole lot of horizontal stretch, in my opinion. And definitely not a lot of vertical stretch here. So a sweater would be nice considering it's one of those high traffic items. Also blankets, because those again are high traffic and they won't stretch out of shape super fast, which is great. Could also do scarves, like gift scarves, things like that. I think that would be ideal for this project. Anywho, I hope that you enjoyed today's tutorial. If so, don't forget to leave this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on future knitting content. I typically post knitting tutorials on Wednesdays at 9:30 a.m. CST. You can check me out over on Instagram where I post all my knitting and crochet whips and projects and pattern releases. So you don't want to miss out on that. Or you can sign up for my newsletter on my website so you can be one of the first to know when I drop a new design or have other crafty news. And until next time, guys, happy making.